I'm so angry. I told you I'm an angry master. Yeah. When it comes to the animals and the children, because they're the most helpless, most vulnerable.
Yes, Master.
I could not do the video conference today. I almost could not do it, even by the phone, but I had to. I had to talk to you about this so that you can understand more why I am angry, okay?
Yes, Master. Yes, Master.
And why these things are the cancer of the society, of the world, the big world, big cancer, big, ugly, filthy cancer that has to be cut off. Otherwise, it infects the whole world. And nobody will believe in the teaching of Jesus if it continues this way. There will be more harm done. Do you understand?
Yes, Master.
To deny a cancer is to not seek the cure and not try to heal it. So they have to do something more obvious than this, more obvious than just here and there a little bit, here and there and all that, and just promising and doing nothing all these years, all these decades already. And how many more tens of thousands of children, little boys, little girls, have to suffer until they open their mouth and do something?
I was groomed starting young.
The day I met him, I was around 18 months old.
They targeted me because I was fatherless.
I was in my diaper, and I ran out and ran right to him.
We were taught, I mean, the priests and the nuns are God.
Just think, like, the word God makes me think of him, and I just...
You're being groomed to get used to a grown man's hands, you know, on you regularly.
So he would always have his hands on me.
When you have the priest touching you every day, you know, that's a hard memory to have. And the church covered it up.
Who would have believed me, a priest in 1948 or 47 would abuse you, do that? Never heard of such a thing because they covered it up.
It doesn't ever go away. It has an effect on you for the rest of your life.
These are people that these priests ruined their lives, and they still, at 83 years old, still affects him.
I just feel like I've, like, my whole life has been a lie.
Has absolutely destroyed me.
My children suffered. My wife suffered. I couldn't show any affection with my wife.
I had no desire to have children. None. Because of this.
My children I couldn't hold or hug.
I didn't feel comfortable at all. I still don't feel comfortable now in relationships.
I remember a poem, some priest in Japan wrote it. Well, anyway, I read it from a Japanese Buddhist book. But it could be the Japanese priest, it could be Chinese. I don't remember which country's priest, okay? But they have even a little reverence for the street girls, the so-called prostitutes, yes?
Yes, Master.
Yes. They are doing it openly and honestly. They sell only what they have. If they have nothing else to sell, society pushed them into this corner already. Everybody looks down upon them. But look at the holy, holy of all the holy people who are supposed to lead the faithful into virtues, morals, and God realization. Look at what they're doing, huh? Behind closed doors, forcing little weak children, towering upon them, squashing them, squashing even the little children's dignity and peace. And they will be traumatized all their lives, these little kids. And don't wonder if they became criminals even.
Right.
For hating this system of holiness, and which is just betraying their faith and their innocence and destroys their lives. Do you hear me?
Yes, Master.
Oh, I'm just so breathless. I'm just so angry. This is a one-sided oppression and bullying. One side, because the children have no say in it.
Yeah, that's right.
They don't even ask their permission or agreement, nothing. This is outright, how you say?
Abuse.
Yeah.
Abuse, of course, but that's not enough of a word for me. I cannot find a better word. Abusing, molesting is nothing. This is evil. You understand me?
Yes, Master. Yes, Master.
This is criminal. I remember the poem written by a Buddhist priest. I don't remember exactly everything. It's just something, okay?
Yes, Master.
Like the Buddha sells the Dharma. The monks sell the Buddha. She sells her body. All to satisfy sentient beings' different desires. I read that. I felt very touched. You understand me?
Yes, Master.
Yes. Yes. It seems not reverent to the Buddha and the monks, but it is so. He is a straightforward and honest person. He does not look down upon the prostitute.
Yes, Master.
Yes. Yes. And long time ago, many 10 years ago, I still had enough time to recite poetry, and I recited one of the poems for the Vietnamese disciples. Not a lot of them at that time. It's something about one of these courtesans, yeah? The prostitute. She's having, of course, a night with one of the clients, yeah? A man on the river, on the boat. It was so romantic with the boat and the moon reflecting in the water, and it was in the night and quiet. And then the girl who worked as the prostitute felt very lonely. And maybe she liked that customer, you know, of hers. And she begged him to stay with her for a while longer. Why so hurried? Because the moon is so bright. As if heaven is having a party, yeah, a festival. So if you leave, my heart will feel too lonely, too lonely. Something like that. I remember all the Vietnamese words, but I'm not in a mood to recite for you right now. If you can, you find it. It's an old-time recitation. Okay, maybe in L.A. they will have a copy somewhere, privately preserved, yes? I'm not sure if they recorded it.
Khách ngồi lại cùng em trong chốc nữa vội vàng chi trăng sáng quá khách ơi đêm nay rằm yến tiệc sáng trên trời khách không ở lòng em cô độc quá khách ngồi lại cùng em đây vội lòng
Tay em đây và hồn của em đây, em cũng đứng bọc dưới chân hoàng tử. Xác tiếng gà trắng ngà lạnh buốt, mắt run mờ kỹ nữ thấy sông trôi. Du khách đi, du khách đã đi rồi.
Tội nghiệp quá ha, có ai biết đâu tâm tình của mấy người kỹ nữ ha. Có nhiều người nhưng mà đâu có người nào yêu đâu ha.
And one of your brothers, Vietnamese brother, asked me, why did you recite such things? You are a monk. Why did you recite poetry talking about a prostitute woman? So I said to him, all very clear in my mind that she is a Buddha. Inside. I say inside her, she has also Buddha nature like you.
Yes.
When I spoke like that, it was very clear to me that it is like that. It is true like that. With all objectivity and reverence.
Yes, Master.
For all beings. For all beings at all. And I still do that.